guarda, dici veramente, io non ho visto una cosa
ma guarda che ha fatto un'opera incredibile
in serie,
but it's all thanks to me.
Well, you should film yourself while you're saying
that. Tu non hai visto che invenzione che è? Cioè, piccola così, c'è un
solo. It's really impressive.
It's only one piece of glass?
Penso di me.
Can I show him one inside that's two pieces? In this toilet, there's a frame of the breccia, the regione breccia. Let me just show you.
Per vedere un altro... Altra cornice.
Sì. This is permanent. This is two pieces of glass, like a sandwich.
Questi sono due pezzi di vetro come un panino.
Sì, sì, un panino. Sì, due sandwich.
But those frames are one piece of glass.
Ma quelli che ha fatto per lei sono un pezzo di vetro.
Anyway, you can see it's sealed. Glass on.
È sigillato.
È un sandwich.
È stupendo, eh?
Sandwich.
Sì, sì.
But, ok, thank you.
Glad you fuori dal bagno anch'io.
Fuori dal bagno. Fuori dal
bagno. Gliele rubo stasera, tutte le cornici.
I have trepidation of what the people are going to think, but most people like it. That's what I'm
doing. Fuori cornici. That's a very good idea. Where would it be? Could one see it?
Eventually, when it's available.
No, but is there, like, if I go to the ground,
Thank you.
here. Don't worry. We can help us.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid of us. Let's get there because I'm really, really glad that we were able to host this exhibition. This exhibition is really extraordinary. It's something that closes a gap, I think, in the knowledge we have of Italian design. Italian design is very well known. It started to have great success and being prominent after the Second World War, but it was inspired and it drove a lot of inspiration from modernism. But soon after the war, there were already people that decided that thought that was not what they were interested in doing. I mean, form and function, you know, Miss van der Rohe, all these concepts, they were not what they felt was due to the time in which they lived. This avant-garde experimentations took various forms in Italy. They started in the 60s, but they had an explosion with this movement, Alchimia, which we have tonight here. Tonight we have an example, I mean many instances, of what it was to go beyond the constraints of certain rules imposed by modernism in design, in the design world. And I'm really honored and I feel it's really, really excited to introduce to you the founder of this movement, Alessandro Guerriero. Before I talk to him, before I give the word to him that we'll talk a bit about this exhibition and what these drawings are and what was their aim when they started this collaborative work, I want to introduce to you, some of you already know, our Consul General of Italy, Tullio Guma, who will also say a few words.
Thank you very much. This is Frisenna, Mr. Guerriero, Mr. Lavetti, co-founders of Alchimia. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome everybody. I'm very happy to be here today for this very interesting exhibition. I just read in the manifesto, they say the Alchimia likes the very act of drawing, and this is what I found when watching these designs and drawings, that they are really very nice. Plenty of color, but also inspired. And so I think that once more I want to congratulate with you because it is certainly a success exhibition, of course. Many congratulations to the founder. I heard that the exhibition will remain until December.
Yes.
So I hope that many Torontonians could come and enjoy this exhibition. I don't have other words to say, but again, thank you very much also for coming to Toronto, and I wish you the best success for your exhibition and also for the future of your activities.
Grazie.
Alessandro Guerriero is a very interesting person. The more you talk to him, the more you would like to go on talking. He's not the person that enjoys being on the spotlight, but enjoys doing things a lot, I think. His career has been extraordinary. He has created this movement together with Alessandro Mendini and other prominent architects, designers, visual artists, graphic designers, people of the fashion world, people of the theater. So he has shown all his life such an energy, putting together people of different disciplines and asking them to work on different projects. For this energy doesn't simply go towards the world of design, but also towards the world of education, which I find, as a former educator, very, very interesting. He has created a school, Domus Academy, he's founded it, and he is now in the advisory board of NABA, which is the Nuova Accademia di Belle Arti in Milan, and he has found in Ravenna another school which is called Futurarium, and his latest idea was to create a school in Milan which is completely free of charge. Maybe if you're interested, you can talk also about that, because I think it's one of those utopian projects that reflect his personality a lot, but is also inspiring for all of us. What else? He has also worked in the world of magazines. He has worked in Domus, and he has created magazines, all of them with a different twist. Something was beyond the idea of a magazine. They were always something more than that. So for all his achievements, he has been awarded a Compasso d'Oro in 84, okay. And many other rewards. But he is a very shy person, a person that we would call unassuming. And this is, I think, what characterizes him. So, with this, I think now it's time that he talks, so that I end up talking, and that you can hear from his own words what Alchimia was and how it was created. By the way, we have the manifesto in the other room, I don't know if you've noticed. It's in English and Italian of the movement, because it was a real movement, and a catalogue with contributions by Mendini and by François Bucart. Okay.
E c'è anche il film.
Yes, and the film. Thank you for reminding me.
Abbiamo tutti i pezzi.
There is also a movie that in. Fortunately made with interviews to all the participants of the movement. It's called the Santa Alchimia, and you can see it in the other room on the screen.
Bello titolo, yes. Buonasera, grazie per essere venuti.
Good evening, thank you for being here.
Io non so cosa mi rimane da dire oltre a quello che ha detto la dottoressa.
He doesn't know what more to say other than what
Dr.
Frisenna said.
Ha detto tutte le cose più belle che io non potrei dire di me.
She said all the most beautiful things that can be said about himself that he cannot say about himself.
Però questa mostra è stata proprio benissima, è stata proprio precisa, bella, come piacciono a me.
He really likes the way the exhibit has
been perfetta nelle misure, nelle cose, e soprattutto c'è questa cornice che mi ha esaltato, che ha fatto questo signore.
It is perfect in its dimensions and its. I've never had such beautiful frames for my work. I promise.
These
frames are a work of art.
Later on, we will ask our artist, because I call him an artist, to describe the method he uses, employs for this frame.
Qui abbiamo mandato una selezione di disegni che sono in verità rappresentano, sono tantissimi, rappresentano già scusate.
We have here a collection of drawings that represent various.
Grosso modo 15-17 anni di attività.
They represent about 15-17 years of activity.
E gli altri sono tutti in un magazzino, tutti in fila.
And the others are all in storage, all in a row, neatly.
E la storia di questi disegni è abbastanza semplice, a volte complessa, cioè semplice nel senso che accompagnano i lavori in design che abbiamo fatto. Cioè ogni volta che facevamo una collezione di design, il disegno accompagna gli oggetti che venivano presentati.
They, most of them are simple and sometimes complex, but mostly simple because the design accompanies the project that we were working on at that time.
E quindi invece di fare le fotografie facevamo le pitture degli oggetti presentati.
So rather than photograph what we were doing our project on, we were painting or drawing or designing, just making drawings of what we were working on.
E invece complessa perché il sistema di progettazione dei lavori pittorici non è come quella classica che c'è un pittore che fa o un disegnatore che fa questi soggetti.
But it's complex because unlike in classical art where you have a designer just painting or drawing what's there.
Ma invece hanno una concezione di lavoro che assomiglia molto all'architettura, or design vero proprio.
But rather they're conceived as an architectural piece, or design per se.
Mi spiego meglio.
I'll be more specific.
Cioè di solito quello che succede nei disegni, che uno fa un piccolo schizzo.
Usually what happens is you make a small drawing of something.
E poi lo dà a un suo collaboratore che lo mette in bella, lo mette in forma di
Then you give your drawing to a collaborator or a colleague. Who will embellish it and make and bring it to a more defined.
E poi c'è un altro collega che invece è un esperto di colore, quindi riesce a capire che quell'azzurro sta bene con l'arancione, gli metti i colori giusti.
And then there's a colleague who, for example, will take a look at color and say, well, this blue is better placed next to this orange.
Allora, al contrario della storia della pittura normale dove c'è una firma sola, qui ci sono tantissime firme dietro.
Well, unlike the history of painting or art, here there is not just one person who signs and is responsible for the work, but many, and many sign it.
Esatto, e tutti sono allo stesso livello progettisti.
And all of them are at the same level as designers.
Io sono arrivato anche a dire in alcuni casi che anche la segretaria che risponde al telefono è progettista, perché se è antipatico il cliente non chiama più.
He has reached a point where he believes that even the secretary who answers the phone is a designer, because if she is not nice to the clients or the people who are calling, well, it's already a failure in itself. So.
Allora questi disegni hanno una caratteristica molto strana in un certo senso, perché sono molto distaccati dalla realtà proprio perché passano di mano in mano.
So these drawings are in some way unusual and strange because they pass, they are not in the hands of one person. They go from one person to another person and to another person.
E tutti questi possono dire, io ho fatto questo quadro.
And each one of these people can say, I'm responsible for this.
Ma nello stesso tempo è completamente antieroica.
But at the same time, it's not heroic in any way. There's not one single hero.
Per cui in alcuni casi appunto è la documentazione degli oggetti fatti, in altri casi sono nati in una maniera molto curiosa che ho spiegato stamattina, che tu ti ricordi, che è quello che
So the origin of many of these works is unusual in that sense that they have their origin in describing a work or a project that is in the course of being made.
Cioè, più delle volte, io non so il telefono, ma a tutti gli succede, no? Che si fanno degli scarabocchi così quando si telefona. Chiaramente dipende da chi telefoni. Se telefoni una fidanzata, fai certi scarabocchi. Se telefoni un'altra, fai altri scarabocchi.
So sometimes what happens is that another inspiration for some of these drawings has been, for example, what happens when you're on the phone and you're just scribbling away on a notepad next to you. You'll be scribbling away and...
Quindi in un certo senso noi qua saremo tutti progettisti.
So in a way, all of us here, così. If we all begin there, we are all designers.
E allora, dopo che si è telefonato, che è venuto fuori questa pagina tutta scarabocchiata, si sceglie un piccolo pezzettino che si dice, mi piace questo pezzettino.
So when you're, if you look carefully, when you've done your little scribble, and you take a piece of that scribble, and just circumscribe it, and pull it out.
Esatto. Poi questo subisce la trasformazione che diciamo prima, cioè passa di mano in mano come se fosse una lavorazione industriale.
So then what happens is this piece that you've pulled out of that scribble is passed on to your colleagues, as he described earlier. as if it was an industrial process. And each person is taking part in the creative process, and each person is looking at a part of that drawing and perfecting it or embellishing it, looking at the color or the curvature or the
quindi detail. Sono piacevoli da un certo punto di vista come effetto decorativo, ma non hanno nessun senso.
So they are very pleasant to the eye in a decorative sense, but they don't have any use per se.
Però tutti questi disegni fatti da decine e decine e centinaia, messi in un magazzino, diventano il materiale principe per poter fare degli oggetti.
So what happens is once he's collected these drawings, these and the collection can reach numbers that are very great, hundreds even. What happens is this becomes a material from which he then can work on different projects in any field.
Esatto. Allora, e qui arrivo alla conclusione perché sennò poi diventa troppo lungo. Siccome noi siamo capiamo e siamo e condividiamo il fatto che ci sono due possibilità di lavorare nelle superfici delle cose o nelle strutture delle cose.
Now I'm going to reach the conclusion of what I'm speaking about. Because when we work on these things, we can look at things on a superficial level or in the structural level, on the level of the structure of things.
Quando si lavora nella superficie del corpo c'è una comunicazione molto veloce con tutti quelli che tu vuoi parlare.
When you work superficially, communication is rapid. You're saying something very rapidly to your audience or to whomever you want to communicate.
Al contrario, nella struttura si ha molta difficoltà perché solamente chi capisce un certo tipo di linguaggio fa parte del tuo gruppo.
Whereas if you're looking at things structurally, you're looking at things in depth. And so the people who are appreciating what you've done are usually experts, people in the field.
Allora noi abbiamo scelto e preferiamo la prima cosa, quella di lavorare in superficie. E abbiamo detto anche che c'è una profondità della superficie, c'è un suo senso della superficie. E in alcuni casi che vedete qua, come per esempio questo, che è un disegno completamente astratto, che non significa assolutamente nulla, diventa per esempio una decor di un vaso. Immaginatevi un vaso, così. Oppure diventa un tappeto, oppure diventa una storia, non ha nessuna limitazione di quello che diventerà.
So basically what happens is they've chosen to work on the superficially. This is what they've chosen to do. In order to then allow the person to see, for example, in this drawing here, to see or to apply what you see to anything you want, to a vase, to a carpet, to a piece of furniture.
An automobile.
Even an automobile. A motorcycle, a bicycle.
E la cosa bella è che ognuno di voi può fare questo usare questo meccanismo, cioè fare il piccolo schizzo, ingrandirlo, metterlo al posto per i colori e poi dire faccio a casa mia la porta.
Each one of you can participate in this creative process. You make a drawing, you make a little scribble, you take from that scribble something that is aesthetically pleasing to you, and then you amplify it, you take it out. And you take that surface and you apply it to something that you might like at home. You might, I don't know, you might want to make a carpet, you might want to paint something of your own, or even a doorway.
Ecco, allora il compito che do loro è questo, ma tra leggo lo stesso giorno e faccio il giro delle case.
So he's coming next year and he's going to come to your homes and he's going to see if you actually apply his technique.
Grazie a tutti.
Thank you so much.
Yes, there are some questions, but before I forget, I want to thank also the people that have worked for this exhibition and have helped this exhibition to be made. First of all, I want to thank Azure Magazine for their support as media sponsor of this exhibition, Alitalia that has also helped us with the flights, and then Remo Rappetti, who has been the coordinator of this exhibition in Milan, and the people of the Istituto, all my co-workers here, but in particular, in this case, I want to thank the gentleman in front of me, Carlo Settembrini, that is really the force behind a lot of these things that we do. Without his expertise and his patience and his dedication to work, we wouldn't realize such a beautiful exhibitions. But also my other colleagues here, I want to thank. So, now please, question.
If you don't mind, I'll ask the question in English and then I'll translate it myself. Buonasera. First of all, a compliment for the variety of work that I see. I'm an architect here in Toronto. Io lo traduco io, non si preoccupi. And I certainly find appealing your notion of democratizing design for everyone. I'm still not clear, though, whether these works are designs that ended in themselves or whether any were actually applied to solid projects. I will now translate. Buonasera, benvenuto tra noi. Chiaramente un applauso per tutto il suo lavoro di tanti anni. E mi attira molto il suo concetto democratico di spargere il design per tutti. Non sono ancora chiaro però se qualcuno di questi disegni o tutti siano stati realizzati anche dopo, fisicamente, su qualche progetto.
Anche dopo, in che senso?
Cioè, questi sono disegni, per esempio quello dietro di lei, da lì, quello della maschera più o meno, è rimasto lì o si è fatto qualche altra cosa? Cioè, qualche scultura, applicazione?
È rimasto lì.
Ho capito.
Ma non in tutti i casi. Non in tutti i casi, per esempio questo qua, come le scarpe là, sono per dimostrare quello che dicevo prima, cioè che stabilendo dei piccoli segni che uno fa per conto suo, che dal punto di vista psicologico sono abbastanza importanti farli, poi vengono applicati su un autoritratto, che sono state le scarpe, e questo è un genere, e in altri casi sono altri generi, là ci sono delle scarpe che hanno un altro decoro, un altro modo di rappresentarsi. Però per me fare quello e fare quelle scarpe lì è quasi la stessa cosa. Hanno due decori diversi, due realizzazioni diverse, due rifiniture diverse, quella più complicata e quella più semplice, ma tutte e due indicano che si possono fare con dei segni semplici delle cose completamente nuove. E difatti, ah, scusa, mi ricordo più? No, scusa, mi ricordo.
Sì, non mi tradurre lei.
No, io
ricordo. Well, yeah. I'll try to summarize all of that. So basically the answer to the question is some of the drawings have their own value per se. Other ones are used and they are applied in other forms. They're used actually as inspiration or actually applied literally to some other object. So some of them, for example, will be used in the design of a pair of shoes. So there will be a fashion designer who will want a certain pair of shoes. This has happened to many occasions like this. And they'll say, can you do this for me? And he'll take that storehouse of drawings that he had, that he spoke about before, he'll take that and he'll apply it to a pair of shoes, to a bicycle, to a motorcycle, to a home.
Dico un'altra cosa, dico che stamattina abbiamo fatto un incontro con l'università che si chiama
George Brown. We were at George Brown College this morning.
Dove abbiamo avuto più tempo di spiegare certe cose evidentemente che qua in questo momento.
We were able to explain in more detail.
Però il nostro ideale, il nostro goal è quello di fare delle immagini che hanno la presunzione di far capire che non si capisce di che periodo siano.
So our goal is to make is to produce something, a design that cannot be identified in time. It's almost anachronistic. You can't look at it and say, oh, this is from this period, or this is from this other period.
Cioè, voi prendete uno per uno questi oggetti, questi quadri.
Take each one by one.
Ed è difficile dire se questo qua è più anni 60 o 1980 o...
Is this the 60s or the 80s?
It's difficult to say. Questo per me è interessante. L'altra cosa interessante per me è che vedendo tutte queste cose, appunto perché si è lavorato in tanti in equipe, sembriamo
tantissime persone diverse, eppure non è così, siamo sempre 3 o 4, 5, 6, fatti di segni.
So when you take all of this work, the total sum of it, you think, oh, wow, how many different artists worked here? And basically it's about a few, between 3 and 6 people. So not that many. But you look at it and you'd say, well, there's a lot of different art pieces here.
Perché abbiamo usato anche un sistema, diciamo, surreale, che è quello che basta cambiare il giro del lavoro, cioè che invece di darlo a un collaboratore si dà un altro, il giro al contrario, che viene fuori da un disegno.
So another thing is they applied an almost surreal method in which they would give the work to one collaborator, but if you did it in the opposite, in a different order, a wholly different work will come up.
Forza.
Any other question?
C'è un premio alla prossima domanda.
Try for the next question.
No, sempre te non va.
No, mi stavo aspettando.
No, signore.
Maestro, uscendo da qui dopo aver visto questa mostra, come dovrei sentirmi per essere in sintonia con l'arte, più felice e più ricco di voi?
Ma questo lo deve dire lei, non più visto. Lo deve
dire lei, how should I feel? Coming out of this room.
Ecco, quando va a casa, cosa che dice Camisto?
Prego.
Quando lei va a casa,
sì.
Cosa dice Camisto suo moglie o suo figlio?
What will you say?
È con me adesso, ma mi sento veramente più ricco. Io
non ho... Grazie.
He feels enriched by the experience of being here.
Come
detto. Una domanda. La faccio in generale,
tra l'altro,
no, molto facile. Cioè, si è detto c'è un primo schizzo, un primo drone, first drone, very first drone, dopodiché continua questo processo, no? Ma c'è uno di questi, forse quello che ha fatto il primo schizzo, che dice questo disegno adesso è completo, cioè c'è uno che prende la responsabilità di dire adesso è completo o finisce l'incanto così?
L'incanto.
L'incanto.
So the question is, when you make that first draft drawing, okay, you begin with that, but at what stage does anyone say, this is complete, this is done, it's finished? Or is there someone who says that, or does it happen magically? The answer is magically.
Questa domanda, apparentemente innocua, è molto complessa, perché è come chiedere se uno si innamora di una persona, e quando è pieno amore e quando finisce e quando non finisce, non lo sai, è tutto uguale. Cioè tu adori una cosa che fai, la fai fino a che tu non esci e sei tutto dentro in quel luogo, no? Sei in quel posto. E allora a quel punto dici che è finita.
So this seems like an innocuous question, very harmless, but it actually isn't that way. Because it's a little bit like when you fall in love with a person, or you love that person. At what stage do you come out of that love feeling that it's complete? And how do you... It happens magically when you're able to look and understand it.
Io, per esempio, ho avuto 4 amori.
I've had 4 wives, not me, okay. 2, but he's had 4, twice as much as me, so, sorry.
Leggo nell'introduzione che Alessandro Guerriero è uno a cui piace cambiare le regole. You're introduced as one that likes to change the rules. Noto in quel disegno a sua destra che la bandiera italiana è messa all'inverso. Dato che abbiamo il console generale d'Italia, c'era qualche cosa spiritosa in quel design?
Che questo
mi sembra. In the drawing, the Italian flag is shown backwards. and I'm inquiring whether there was a spirited purpose related to the introduction that says that he likes to change the rules. Since we have the Italian Consul General here, perhaps that question may be appropriate.
Detto io. Questo disegno è per una mostra che ho fatto a Varsavia.
This is for an exhibit that he did in Warsaw.
Oltre a questo disegno c'è un'ipotesi di grattacieli. Questo era uno.
This was for some presentations regarding high-rise buildings.
Ma quello che ha fatto il disegno, quello che l'ha finito col colore, era un giapponese.
Okay, the person who completed it in its colors was Japanese.
Bastava fare il disegno da di qua, no? Che era giusto.
If you had drawn it the other way, it would be
correct. Allora, la prossima domanda o premio? Spero che dia un premio.
Cioè,
il premio sarà di là.
Certo, certo, certo. So, who wants to have a prize?
La signora
chi vuole avere un premio?
Good evening, thank you. As you were growing up, who inspired you?
Many.
Many inspirations. Meno nella pittura e più nel film, più nella scrittura, più in altre discipline.
Surrealists?
Less in design, but more of his inspiration actually came from cinema and literature. I surrealisti.
Ah beh, sì, certo.
Of course.
Io penso di essere una specie di post-futurista.
He considers himself a post-futurist.
Yes.
No, lo dico io, non lo dicono i critici, purtroppo.
He believes that, but the critics don't say that. He's the creator. They're just looking at it.
Darren, would you like to explain how you made these beautiful frames? Because people have been asking.
Normally I make a frame with two pieces of glass, but these are half frames. There's one piece of glass. We've put a bit of mounting putty on the back of the artwork. The artwork is stuck against the wall. Carl and I figure out the spacing and we prepare the artwork to go on the wall. We put the artwork on the wall. The frames have been made ahead of time, obviously. It's 2mm glass wrapped in 1/2-inch copper. The copper's folded over. It's soldered with lead tin solder, brass wire soldered on all four corners so that it's supported on all four corners. After we put the artwork on the wall, we put the frame up in front of the artwork and literally nail the frame to the wall with 1-inch finishing nails, and that's basically it. After the show's over, we take the frames off the wall, we remove the nails off the wall, the artwork comes off the wall, we gather up the putty and pack them up and send them to the next destination, right? Where will it go next?
But we don't know yet.
But yeah, this was a compromise. When I was first engaged to frame things for the Institute, I was making whole frames, and after the show they'd say, okay, tear it apart and get the artwork out and we're going to send it to the next place. And I said, there must be something, you know, better to, so it's like wasteful, right? Mm-hmm. So that's it. I call them half frames, but they look like the full frames, but if you look at it from the edge, they're only half as thick.
Burbish
Village for the next couple of years.
Burbish Village for those who are interested.
Thank you.
But let me now really open this exhibition. We have some glass of prosecco for you and something to accompany that. And again, thank you very much for.